What's going on, YouTube? Snipes here with TKO Gaming, bringing you guys the trial strategy for the new Trials of the Nine map and game mode, which is Altar of Flames Survival. And so I'm going to get to it. Before we do that, two things I want to talk to you guys about. Number one, actually three things. Number one, as you guys know, Destiny 2 Silver giveaway in this video. All you have to do is like this video and comment down below anything about Destiny 2. Literally, it could be anything. Make sure you're a subscriber and make sure you have notifications on. The way you do that is you hit that bell, and the winner will be DM directly on YouTube. So make sure you check your DMs. Now, the next two things I want to talk to you guys about is, number one, if you need help in Trials of Osiris, as you guys know, we've carried over 4,000 people in Destiny 1. If you want help in Destiny 2, you can do two things. You can come over to our Twitch stream, or you can simply reach out to us by reading the description below. Of course, the people that support us get priority, but everybody has a chance to get a run with TKO Gaming. And then the next thing I want to talk to you guys about is, if anybody wants to be a Trials helper, if you want to be a Sherpa with us, if you want a Beast, please reach out on Twitter. You can just, you know, at RealTKO Gaming, or you could simply message me on PS4 or Xbox One. I'll have the gamer tags pop up on your screen, and that's it. Now let's get into the freaking video. So this is a beautiful freaking map, but the game mode is very, very long. It's about four rounds of eight lives each on each side. So if you played Gears of War, it's essentially that is what this is. What you want to do with a team is, once again, stay together and do not stray off. Oh my god, I cannot say this enough. We are playing a game where we're about to lose, but I thought I'd post this game so I can show you guys exactly what the other team is doing that's so efficient and effective, and what we're doing and what I'm doing specifically that's not. Now, as you guys know, I am not playing with my team. I did this game first thing in the morning right before work, and I did not have my team to play with, but hey, I played with people that were really, really nice and were able to join me on a short notice so I can put this game out for you guys. So, a couple things I want to talk to you guys about. Let's start with the weapon control. What you want to do with weapons for your team. Of course, Mida multi-tool is back, Mida, whatever you want to call it. This scout rifle is OP for this map. This map has a lot of long range and at the same time a lot of angles, and with the speed boost of the Mida multi-tool along with the range, plus the fact that it's a great team shot weapon and it's a good solo shot weapon, this is a great thing to have. Now, if you see what the other team is doing, they're head glitching pretty much. Now, this middle lane that you just saw, it's the most popular lane, so you want to make sure that if you get there, you want to make sure that your teammates are there to support you. Now, my build and my loadout is, I think, is actually really good for this map. I have a shotgun. I think a sniper would be really, really good. Since there's one power weapon, having a really good sniper on your team is very important. I think having your primary as a Mida multi-tool, your secondary as the Last Hope, and your third could be a really good sniper, or it could be a good shotgun. It could be the trial shotgun, which is, I don't remember what it's called, but then it could also be Hawthorne, which is a great, great shotgun, super fast. And you'll see me use it in effect here in this match. And so what you want to do is, you definitely want to preserve lives, but you want to stay together as a team and team shot. And then bait and switch. And that's the most important thing, because when somebody is shooting you, you want to be able to get the hell out of that gunfight if you're not going to win. Especially if you have outnumbered, like let's say the other team has more than one person shooting at you. Like, you know, for example, when you're in middle lane and there's like three or four people. So what I'll do is I'll peek shot a grenade and I'll throw it on. I mean, you could still take some damage, but then just make sure that you can get out of that gunfight. Because in survival, your lives are very, very important. So the first couple rounds, I didn't die much. But then when I did end up dying, we already had no lives. So I was really trying to urge my teammates to, hey, let's stick together. We need to watch each other's angles. Now, that middle lane is very, very popular, but that right flank lane is very popular as well. Now, if you cannot outgun your team in the middle lane, then stop peeking it. And this is something I'm saying to myself, because I'm thinking we're gonna have some good team shots together and we're gonna be able to do this, but nope, that's not the case. We're getting outgunned nearly every time because that other team's team shots are just better than ours. And then Mida multi-tool, of course, is the go-to weapon. So I'm pretty sure everybody on that team was using it, and I think two or three people, we should all have been using it as well. But we're thinking, hey, you know what, maybe we won't have to use that. Maybe we can use, you know, I don't know, a nightshade or something. Some other weapons I would definitely recommend for this map is a good long range auto rifle. It could be the Trials auto rifle. It could be the Uriel's Gift. That's a great auto rifle too. So I would recommend those two. And then the power weapon, the other team actually use rocket launchers, which I believe if you have a really good rocket, I think it could be effective, considering you can really, in Trials and in most playlists in Destiny 2, teams will most likely be sticking together. So if you can hit them with a good rocket and either damage them all or just be able to, I don't know, kill them all, so then you'll be able to get some good kills with the rocket. And so I use a shotgun because I think it's a little bit more effective, but I definitely don't blame people that use rockets, especially ones that give you a lot of ammo. So as you guys can tell, I mean, towards the end of the game, they all have their supers. There's really nothing that we can do to counter this. You know, there's really, really nothing we can do. Plus, I also had my PvE set up for Arc Warlock, which has Landfall. Don't use that skill tree. Use the bottom skill tree. Other than that, I really hope these little tips and tricks for this map help you out. Really, the weapon loadouts are very important, and then obviously the team orientation is very important. But we'll see you guys in the next video. I'll probably have another video about Trials dropping, some good information for you guys. Hopefully a lot more videos to come. As you guys know, make sure you subscribe, because at 75k I'm going to be doing a big giveaway, and at 100k I'm going to be doing an even bigger giveaway. So the sooner we can get to that, the sooner we're just going to be able to beast and grow as a family. We'll see you guys in the Twitch stream. We'll be live, not as much this weekend, but we'll definitely be live, and you can still reach out to us if you need to carry offline. We don't need to be live, so make sure you read the description below. You can reach out to us. I love you guys so much. We'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for all the love and support. Peace out.